Yo, what a gang, what a squad, it's a girl, Lizzy Kitty, back here with another video. Today is kind of not a nice video, it's kind of a sad one. Okay, let me turn off the light. But walk back. Oh, is that, it's not actually too loud. Yeah. So yeah. Today is not a happy video. It is a really upsetting video. I'm going to tell you the truth of my life. What's been going on. So yeah. It's literally, this is called Discuss My Life. I would do a Draw My Life, but I'm gonna do that my when I'm older. So yeah. But this is like half my life going on. So yeah. On the day of September 13th, 2004, my mom had me and my brother. We were twins. We were born in the Dominican Republic in Punta Cana. We moved here in like, I don't know, 2010 or 2009, I'm not sure. I thought America was a scary place because there was no one who spoke Spanish. It was like, it was crazy. And I heard something about school. I was afraid to go to school because I was mostly the quiet one. So every day when I would go to school, I would just sit there and do nothing. Like, you know, don't do anything. But yeah, my teacher, she tried to make me have friends, but I didn't want any friends. I would just be like, no, like, you know, talk to the kids. Like, that's how I would always be like when I was little. Now it's like, okay, very social. So, past all that, fifth grade is coming along. Third, fourth, and fifth were like my terrible years. Because, one, I mostly screwed up half my life there because I think my dad was with me, and in third grade it kind of, you know, something bad happened. My only friend was the man. It was really terrible. Even sometimes he would go away too. So when I graduated third grade, I went to fourth, and I turned 10. So yeah, me and my parents went on a Thanksgiving vacation to Orlando, and we went to the pool and everything. We went to the beach. It was fun. But then my mom got into an argument with my dad, and she said for him to leave. So he said, fine then, I'll leave. My dad got all his stuff and left. Because there was a secret that he was keeping away from my mom. And a secret he kept away from me. He was cheating on my mom. Apparently he didn't want one wife, but another. So, what else that happened is that when we came back, I called him and I asked him, when is he coming home? He said, I'm gonna come home later. So I waited for him at the stairs where I usually wait. He comes home. He works at a dealership. He comes home at 8 o'clock every night. He didn't show up. So, the next day I waited. I just kept on waiting. Soon enough we reach Neverland.
I called him again. I'm like, when are you coming home? He's like, I'm on a business trip. I'll be back before you know it. And I said, Are you gonna abandon me? Or are you gonna stay with me my entire life? And he made a promise. I told him, are you ever gonna leave me? He said, He said, no, you're my only child, and I love you no matter what, no matter the possibilities or what happens. So, we found out that he was cheating, and he had two other daughters, and I started to think he's replacing me. He's replacing me. With these two other daughters. I always want to ask him the question, do you even love me? He wouldn't even answer. He wants me to move in with him because he would love that. But I always say, but I have a life with mommy, and you've had that life too. You just left it all to rot. It's hard for me to deal with this because I can't stop thinking of all the memories we had together. All the memories I had spending with my dad. They were amazing. He loved me and I loved him. He was always there for me, and to think now of the other things that are think of the possibilities that are happening. I can't. So now me going to 7th grade. Me growing up right now, I can't grow up without him. He said he would always stay in my life, stay in the future with me. How are you gonna stay with me if you're not here anymore? I want you by my side. I miss him a whole lot. But there's possibilities of what we have that I need to deal with him. Because lots of things went through him, and you know, my family has been changing. I've been more depressed and more upset lately. Mostly been having suicidal thoughts, which is planning to kill myself. But I already got that covered with him. He doesn't want me to do it, and I'm not gonna do it because what's wasting your life gonna do if you're losing someone? I'm not losing someone. I'm not gonna lose someone. They're gonna lose me. That's more upsetting. So now it's different. You know, things change. The reason why I want to make this video and me to share my feelings with you guys is because lots of my family, lots of my friends, lots of my viewers, they really don't understand what I'm going through. So I had to make a video me explain it. So yeah, that's clearly half of the truth of my story. I cannot say the full truth because I don't want to go out and keep on crying and stuff. But I will take it. I talk about this shit for like an hour, so yeah. Thank you guys so much for enjoying the video. If you want more, if you want to hear the full truth of my story, please comment down below. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe. If you guys can like this video, comment, say that you like and subscribe, and turn the notification. Shimanger, then I will. I'm gonna say, let's make it up to, if this video can get either, I'm gonna say 15 likes, then I will make a part two on this, because I care for what you have to say, and I really do. So yeah, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. But
catch my flight, so you don't gotta wait on me. No, you don't wanna.